Philip, or Metacomet, was like other Native Americans, fed up with Massachusetts Bay and Plymouth Colony settlers taking over their land and pushing them further east. He led the Wampanoag tribe to war against the colonists. Although the Native Americans were fierce fighters, they ultimately lost to the colonists as they were outnumbered and had inferior weapons.
$100.25. I've heard about Britain's Tea Act, but I had no idea it'd be this bad.
Thomas Paine's common sense finally sparked the idea of independence in the minds of the colonists. The colonists began to protest the taxes before this pamphlet. However, these protests did not turn violent until the Boston Massacre of 1770, when a bullet was accidentally fired into a crowd of colonists, causing mass chaos. This was the turning point that led to the revolution itself. America had a lot of advantages during the war. For example, Britain underestimated the power of the colonists, as well as the fact that Americans didn't fight traditionally, and because of this, were allowed to kill more redcoats.
Bloody hell! The Americans should have been here by now!
These factors at hand allowed America to win the war, as well as their independence.
Slavery was arguably the most important factor that caused the Civil War. The issue had been heavily debated for years, but the masses of the argument didn't show up until the 1800s. This debate between North and South greatly increased sectionalism and led to the Compromise of 1850, which did many things, including overturning the Missouri Compromise, passing the Fugitive Slave Acts, and allowed popular sovereignty to decide slavery in the new territory. The debate remained mostly political until 1856, when Massachusetts Senate Charles Sumner offended a relative of Preston Brooks in his The Crime Against Kansas speech. Brooks took this insult to heart and later beat Sumner with a cane, transitioning the slave debate into violence. These acts of violence were seen on a larger scale, with events such as John Brown's raid on Harper's Ferry, as well as Bleeding Kansas, which lasted until 1861, the start of the Civil War. A year before the war started, 7 southern states seceded into the Confederate States of America. This number increased to 11 after the Battle of Fort Sumter. The Union resupplied soldiers to the fort. This angered the South, as they wanted the fort as well. The South barricaded the Union troops in and began to bombard the fort. After 2 days, Major Robert Anderson surrendered the fort. After several years and numerous battles, such as the Battle of Gettysburg, the bloodiest battle in American history, the South agreed to rejoin the Union, thus ending the Civil War.
Hello. I'm Gabriel Prinza. I'm an assassin hired by the Black Hand. I was sitting at this cafe when I noticed my target across the street. The date? It's June 28th, 1914, the day that I killed Franz Ferdinand.
The murder of Archduke Franz Ferdinand is largely believed to be what caused the start of World War I. During the beginning of the war, Austria just simply could not keep up with the enemy forces. This is when Germany stepped in. They fought against the French and the Russians. During this time period, many advancements in the war were created. One of these was the trench warfare, where soldiers would hide in trenches and advance when the whistle was blown.
Private
There were were also technological advancements such as tanks and mustard gas. America and its allies won World War I, and Germany had many restrictions put onto it under the Treaty of Versailles.
September 1st, 1939, marked the day that Germany invaded Poland. After 2 days, Neville Chamberlain, Prime Minister of Britain, declared war on Germany, along with France, Australia, and New Zealand. 2 days after the declaration of war, the U.S. declared its neutrality. 2 years after this, Japanese fighter pilots took off and bombed Pearl Harbor. The next day, the U.S. declared war on Japan. Germany, an ally of Japan, was later attacked in an event now known as D-Day. A year after D-Day, the U.S. bombed Hiroshima and Nagasaki starting on August 6th. This effectively caused Japan to surrender, effectively ending the Second World War.
North Vietnam attacking the Maddox, a U.S. destroyer, in the Gulf of Tonkin, caused the U.S. to write the Gulf of Tonkin Resolution, effectively allowing the deployment of U.S. troops in Vietnamese combat zones. During combat, Vietnamese soldiers used tunnels in order to move troops and weapons and ambush American soldiers. Vietnamese also relied on traps to slow down the U.S. troops. Punchy sticks were a Vietnamese favorite. They would stick sharp sticks, often covered with human feces, in a pit, then cover the pit with leaves and sticks. They would wait until the U.S. troops stepped on the sticks, fell through, and into the trap. This ended up being one of the few wars in which the U.S. was not victorious. After U.S. soldiers pulled out of South Vietnam, the North Vietnamese were able to take over all of Vietnam, and Vietnam became a communist country.
Wait, wasn't a bee supposed to die in this war?
You're still here? It's over. Go home.